Some nights I stay up, cashing in my bad luck. Some nights I call it a draw. Some nights I wish that my lips could build a castle. Some nights I wish they'd just fall off. But I still wake up, I still see a ghost. Oh Lord, I'm still not sure what I stand for.
Gene, are you doing okay? You've been like this since Diddy went on his honeymoon after he and Dixie got married.
I just miss my little buddy, that's all.
I know, we miss him too. Damn it! I forgot!
What, that today's Laurel's birthday?
Yeah, she's totally gonna slap and demote me for this. How about we review Wreck-It Ralph for her birthday? Since Sonic and I are planning on reviewing Ralph Breaks the Internet in 10 days. That's a great idea, Sonic. Let's call Dimension 23 Sonic and tell him about this. Great idea, Sonic!
Hey, cat girl!
Hey.
Why are you down? You can't be down on your birthday.
Well, I can't help it. I'm now 20 years old.
And that's a problem because...
I miss him.
Ooh.
Oh. You mean your mom and dad, huh? I just want them here to see their daughter now an adult. They miss my first day of high school, prom night, high school graduation, starting college, and meeting the love of my life.
I know how that feels. I know what it's like to lose a family member. But luckily, I met you and brought a little sunshine back into your life after your loss, and you gaining your powers. Look at where we are now. You have many friends from different dimensions. You have an older brother and sister. And let's not forget about Eugene. All your friends that you've made these past few years are not just only your friends, but your family. I bet you $23.76 that your brother doesn't want you down on this special day in your life.
You're right. Thanks, Sonic.
Hey, I may deal with PTSD, but I'm totally willing to help out those who are dealing with depression.
Right.
So, what do you want to do today on your birthday?
Honestly, I don't know.
Hello, Sonic's the name, Speed's my game.
Hola, Senor Sonic. Como estas?
I don't remember getting a plane ticket to Mexico and a reservation to the world's largest taco shack. Is there a receptionist who speaks English here?
That's because I'm not fluent in Spanish, you old dotehead.
Sonic, I swear to Jiminy Christmas, if this is your first time prank calling someone, then you did a shitty job at it. Is there a prize for the world's shittiest prank call?
Well, I called you for two reasons. One, to prank call you. And two, I have an idea for what you could possibly do for Laurel's birthday.
Oh, really now? Then what is it? A plane ticket to Mexico and a reservation to the world's largest taco shack? You know Eugene and his love of tacos.
No! I want you to come to our dimension and review Wreck-It Ralph with us.
Wreck-It Ralph? As in the movie that I had a brief cameo as a public server announcer where I warn people not to die outside their own video games?
Yes, that Wreck-It Ralph. So are you coming or not?
Absolutely. I'll go tell her right away.
You guys know I can listen, right?
Fuck! I had the speakers on!
You had one job, Dimension 23 Sonic. That's 23 in Spanish, by the way.
You answer the phone in Spanish, you adult head! Is that why you had to say the Spanish translation for the number 23?
Yes.
Very well then. Un poco loco, Sonic. We should be arriving in about 30 seconds.
Good.
And you better not speak any more Spanish when we get there!
Sin promesas.
Sonic!
Shall we?
So, we got invited to review Wreck-It Ralph on my birthday, huh? This should be fun.
Then what are we standing around doing nothing for? Let us go.
Tomato go?
What?
You said, let us go. Because, you know, lettuce is a vegetable.
You've been spending way too much time with 76 Sonic and Seanic, haven't you?
Yep.
Well then, in all seriousness, let us go.
Ah, Laurel, Diddy and Dixie Sonic. Just in time.
Surprise!
Boys, this isn't a surprise party. You didn't need to shout surprise!
Besides, I already called them telling them our plan to review Wreck-It Ralph.
Oh man, Wreck-It Ralph is such a great movie.
Yeah, it is.
Sis, have you been doing okay?
Yeah, I've been doing okay.
You miss Diddy, don't you?
Yes, I miss him. I wish he didn't have to leave right away.
You do realize that Donkey Kong's wedding present to Diddy and Dixie was a month's stay at the Northern Cremosphere. By the way, what is the Northern Cremosphere?
It's the main hub world of DKC3, Dimension 23, bro.
You know, I've been trying to get myself into playing the Donkey Kong Country games.
Really? Cool, Laurel! They're $8.99 each in the Nintendo's eShop. They are really amazing games, but DKC2 is the best DKC game.
Hey, didn't you go through the same plotline of DKC2 and Mario, Sonic, and Diddy Kong's quests? Shit! I forgot rule number one of being around with Gene. Don't bring up you know what.
You had one job, Sonic, and you blew it.
Be happy that you didn't bring up anything about her dad being dead. Shit! I did it again!
Seriously, will you guys ever learn?
Exactly. Let me handle this. Just don't listen to those silly hooligans, Gene. We're all here for you.
Silly indeed. But they should know better.
Shall we?
Anyway, since everybody is clearly distracted, shall we begin?
We shall. In the year 2012, a couple of years after Tangled, Disney Animation Studios released Wreck-It Ralph, a movie about video game villain who wants more in his life.
I've seen a lot of people compare Wreck-It Ralph to Who Framed Roger Rabbit, and I could totally see it. Both Wreck-It Ralph and Roger Rabbit have similar concepts. A bunch of cartoon characters from different cartoons like Mickey Mouse and Bugs Bunny, while having his own original cast of tunes like Roger Rabbit and Jessica Rabbit. Wreck-It Ralph has a lot of cameos from well-known video games like Pac-Man, Street Fighter, Dance Dance Revolution, Root Beer Tapper, Q-Bert, and the one and only Sonic the Hedgehog.
That's us!
And yes, it features three original games created for the film. Fix-It Felix Jr., Heroes Duty, and Sweet Sweet Canyon. Sugar Rush.
What about Sweet Mountain from Sonic Colors?
And Desert Ruins Zone 3 in Sonic Lost World.
Yes, those two. It was something that Disney has never done before. That is, explore the world of video games. Now let's put it in our quarters and slam our fists on the start button and take a look at Wreck-It Ralph.
The whole film takes place in Late Lad's arcade. And much like Andy's bedroom in Toy Story, when the arcade closes, the various game characters conjugate in Game Central Station through the power cables. Here we see cameos from games like Dance Dance Revolution and Street Fighters. In the game Fix-It Felix Jr., the character celebrates the game's hero, but shuns its villain, Wreck-It Ralph, played by John C. Reilly.
Here's how the game works. You play as Fix-It Felix Jr., who is voiced by Jack McBrayer, as Ralph does his job wrecking the building. Your job as the player is to use your magic hammer and repair broken windows, and you can collect pies, too. At the end of each level, the Nice Landers award Felix with a medal, and they lift up Ralph and toss him to the bottom of the building into a puddle of mud. Oh man, I wish that were a real game. You and me both.
At a support group for video game villains, that is, with Eggman, Bowser, and Bison and other villains from video games, Ralph reveals that he doesn't want to be a bad guy anymore.
Here's Johnny!
Oh, fuck.
Well, if it isn't Dumb and Dumber.
Really? Jim Carrey jokes on someone's special day?
Either it could be two things. You came here to wish me a happy birthday, or are you here just to be a dick and ruin this movie review like you always do?
Both! Also, I'd like to order some cookies from the Girl Scout.
Nobody gets a Schwartz about the damn cookies!
Really? Ben Schwartz? You just had to bring him into the mix, didn't you?
Yeah, Ben Schwartz is a cool dude. I can't wait to see where he takes the role of Sonic. Also, wanna know who isn't a cool dude? Let me give you a hint. He looks like James Halliday's hidden treasure, and he smells like he hasn't worn deodorant in 3 consecutive years.
At least he doesn't call me anything.
And I'm not in the mood to call you anything, G-Ned. Also, reviewing Wreck-It Ralph, are we? The movie that I was in, which I had absolutely no speaking lines whatsoever. They could have at least brought in Mike Pollock to record me saying, I'm bad, and that's good. I will never be good, and that's not bad. There's no one I'd rather be than me.
Trust me, it would sound way stupider if it was Jim Carrey who said that. Burn!
At least Jim Carrey wasn't in Pixels, right, 76 Sonic?
Oh, hell no. You did not bring up that dumb movie with the video game aliens.
Now you're gonna get it, Dr. A. Carrie!
Yeah, that went way too far, and I have a message for you, Baldy McTaco Bell. Get the hell out of here right now!
I don't recall Jordan Peele creating a horror movie called Get the Hell Out Right Now. It was simply called Get Out!
Frankly, my dear, I don't give a damn! You ruined my birthday!
I guess Eggman got carried away.
You could have just asked before borrowing my sunglasses.
Sorry, Sonic. They were on the table, and I wanted to do my absolute worst impression of you ever.
He was pretty bad. Now let's get back on track before we get even more carried away. Damn it, Gene! Now you made me say it!
After saying the bad guy pledge, which the Grinch in the mask just recited, Ralph steals Pac-Man's cherries and heads back to Game Central Station. And while Ralph is heading back to his game, he gets stopped by Surge Projector, where he's called himself Lara Croft. And a direct reference to the Tomb Raider series. On his way back to the game, Fixit Felix Jr., eventually we see me, or 76 Sonic, giving a PSA announcement for Game Central Station.
If you leave your game, stay safe, stay alert, and whatever you do, don't die. Because if you die outside your own game, you don't regenerate. Ever. Game over. And if you leave your cartoon world, be careful not to get covered in a toxic chemical called DIM, which is deadly to toons in the world of Who Framed Roger Rabbit. And if you leave your LEGO universe, don't get hit by Sonic's LEGO washer. That is, if you're made up of pure LEGO.
Also, didn't a certain wolf made a screenshot of 76 Sonic during a movie night that was held on Gene's 25th birthday?
7.8 out of 10. Needs more Sonic.
What the fuck, David?
I remember downloading those screenshots and drawing a red and white vest on one of them, and the other had a red and white bathrobe.
Says, really?
Returning to his own game, Ralph finds the other characters celebrating their game's anniversary and that he was not invited, but they somehow invited Pac-Man, even though that cherry-chasing dot muncher isn't even a part of that game. Felix reluctantly invites Ralph to join them, but the others shun him, saying that he'd have to win a gold medal, just as Felix does. And one of the Nicelanders is named Big Gene.
Are you calling me fat, Sonic?
No! I would never do that! And yes, that's Gene with a G.
Sup, Big Gene?
He deserves it.
I know I still have the baby weight still on, but I will lose it off in the next few months, I promise.
Also, Dimension 23 Sonic or 76 Sonic was at the party too.
Glad I was finally invited to a party. I still can't believe Laurel and myself weren't invited to 76 Sonic and Seanic's bathrobe party a year ago.
You will soon, I promise you. While visiting Tapper, in the game Root Beer Tapper, Ralph meets Markowski, a soldier from the first-person shooter game Heroes Duty, who tells him the game's winner receives a medal. But before that, he looks through his storage closet and finds a box containing one of Mario's mushrooms, and the exclamation point for Metal Gear Solid, and rolls a pair of Zangief's underpants, which was kinda gross. Ralph enters the game and encounters Sergeant Calhoun, his no-nonsense leader, who is voiced by Jane Lynch. He goes through the game session, and is the one to end it. Also, here's how Heroes Duty works. It's pretty much a first-person shooter that works kinda like Time Crisis, where you have to pick up the plastic gun, and shoot enemies on the screen, kinda like in Halo. All the player has to do is shoot the side bugs, and get to the top of the tower to win a medal. But because of Ralph's fuck-ups, the girl who was playing the game got a game over, and it gets reprimanded by Calhoun, and is given a basic reminder of how the game works. Meanwhile, Ralph's absence has not gone unnoticed, as the girl who recently got game over in Heroes Duty, and couldn't play Sugar Rush because a bunch of guys who got lunch at Subway decide to play as all the racers. And she decides to play Fixit Felix Jr. But there's one problem. Ralph isn't there. She tells Mr. Litwick that Fixit Felix Jr. is malfunctioning, and he puts an out-of-order sign onto the game's screen, meaning that all hell has broken loose for the game. Cubert travels to Fixit Felix Jr., since he witnessed Ralph heading to Heroes Duty, tells him all about the dark turn of events. And this time, unlike in Pixels, he talks in Cubertese, and he wasn't like,
"Hey, Felix! I've come to warn you! I just recently saw Ralph heading towards Heroes Duty wearing a Master Chief costume! I think he's gone Tamer! You better come rescue him as soon as fucking possible, if you don't want your game to be unplugged like mine did!"
This causes an alarm for Felix, because if a game becomes broken, Litwack will have to unplug the game, leaving any characters in the game homeless. So Felix sets out to find Ralph.
Your mission, should you choose to accept it. Set out and find Ralph before the arcade opens in the morning, before your game gets unplugged forever. Do whatever you can to stop him from going turbo. Disable self-destruct in 5 seconds. Good luck, Agent Fixit Felix Jr.
Oh my god, you just quoted Mission Impossible!
Yet I haven't seen any of the movies. Not even Mission Impossible Fallout. I take it I'm demoted, aren't I?
Si, senora!
Again with the Spanish.
Sometimes you have to express your surprise and shock in a language that's not English. After the arcade closes, Ralph climbs Heroes Duty's central beacon, which happened to be filled with the eggs of cybugs, which are bug-like enemies, and collects the metal. However, he accidentally hatches a cybug that clings to him. During his panic to get the cybug larva off, he stumbles into a nearby escape pod that launches him out of the game and makes Sonic lose his rings.
Kind of like a certain son of ours did to 76 Sonic and Dimension 23 Sonic at Diddy and Dixie's wedding.
Oh, don't remind me! Your son threw it hard and it hurt!
Ralph crash lands in Sugar Rush, a kart racing game that, as David mentioned, looks like Sweet Sweet Canyon in Mario Kart 8.
I wonder if Sweet Sweet Canyon was inspired by Sugar Rush. Probably!
And Sweet Mountain in Sonic Colors and Desert Ruins in Sonic Lost World.
Actually, Sonic Colors came out before Wreck-It Ralph, if you recall.
Whoops, silly me. Oh yeah, I remember. Sonic Colors came out on November 11th, 2010.
As he searches for his medal, he meets Vanellope von Schweetz, voiced by Sarah Silverman, a glitchy character who makes off with the medal, planning to use it to buy entry into an after-hours race to determine the next day's roster for Sugar Rush. However, King Candy, played by the ever-talented Alan Tudyk, and the other racers refuse to let Vanellope participate, saying she's not really part of the game. One of the racers, Taffeta Muttonfudge, is actually played by Mindy Kaling, who you might probably know as Disgust from Inside Out.
Ralph is then captured by King Candy and his donut police officers, Winchell and Duncan, which are clever nods to Dunkin' Donuts and Winchell's Donuts. Also, his castle has guards who are basically Oreo cookies, and they do the Wizard of Oz guard chant, where they keep saying, "Oreo, Oreo, Oreo, Oreo." Just be glad the wicked bitch of the West didn't hear that.
Oh my
my god! Rick and Fish of the West! That's perfect! Oh, this is coming from someone who loves The Wizard of Oz!
Ralph even makes a really clever nod to Stephen King by calling Vanellope one of the Children of the Candy Corn.
Wait, I don't get it.
Because Stephen King wrote a story called Children of the Corn. It's about a couple of people who travel Midwest, find the body of a murdered child, and they find themselves wandering in a town populated by all children, who all want to sacrifice them to their demonic deity.
No thanks. I'll pass.
I thought you might say that.
The other racers pay her a visit while she is building her own cart and destroy it, disabling her from racing. Ralph witnesses this and scares the racers off. Ralph then berates her, but she insults him right back. This angers him to the point that he smashes a jawbreaker in half.
Well, Ed and Eddie aren't going to be happy with you, Ralph. You broke their favorite jawbreakers. You know, there actually is a character in Ed and Eddie named Rolf. That's R-O-L-F. So I guess that must have been an intentional Easter egg. I doubt it.
Because of his amazing strength, Vanellope gets an idea. She explains to Ralph that the medal can be won back if she gets first place in a race. She then offers to make a pact that if he can help her win, she'll give Ralph the medal back. Ralph reluctantly accepts her offer. After making said pact, they head off to the cart bakery where the racers make their carts, and they build a cart together. However, a security guard notices the unauthorized activity, and the authorities are sent out, along with King Candy. After a long chase, they give King Candy's party the slip by hiding in Diacola Mountain, an incomplete extra racetrack. It is discovered that this is Vanellope's home. From there, Ralph teaches Vanellope how to drive her new cart. And David, don't you dare make any comments about me needing driving lessons myself!
Back in Heroes Duty, Felix meets Sergeant Kowloon, who explains that the Cybugs can control any game and then destroy everything in the said game.
Imagine if the Cybugs took control of Sonic 06.
Then we would have to band together to fight off those motherfuckers and stop them from ruining our games.
As the two search for Ralph and the Cybug and Sugar Rush, Felix explains that he is searching for Ralph, who had probably gone turbo. When Kowloon asks Felix about this term, he then explains that a long time ago, there was an old racing game called Turbo Time, starring a self-observed racer named Turbo, who kept saying, "Turbo-tastic!" One day, a Road Blaster's arcade cabinet entered in the arcade and gained more popularity than Turbo Time. Out of jealousy, Turbo interrupts the game. He traveled to the other game and crashed it into the main player of the new racing game. By doing that, he crashed both games, which led to both of them being unplugged.
As Felix and Kowloon progress, they fix the pod Ralph was in and fly off to search for the lone Cybug. Felix later falls in love with Kowloon.
And you see that they find themselves in Nesquik Sand. In order to get out, they would need to be pulled out by Laffy Taffy. And what better way to do that than to have Kowloon bitch slap Felix while he fixes his bruises with his mighty hammer. However, Kowloon's past comes back to haunt her when Felix refers to her as a dynamite gal. Something that her fiancé, who was eaten by Cybug on their wedding day, would call her.
I can imagine Eugene calling me a dynamite gal.
Well, I can say that Gene is one dynamite gal.
I know my brother would say that about Sonar.
That's right. So anyway, distraught about being called a dynamite gal, Kowloon forces Felix to leave her ship. A heartbroken Felix walks over to King Candy's castle and meets Sour Bill, King Candy's assistant. He locks up Felix after he realizes he should have locked up Ralph. After a long search, Kowloon soon discovers that the Cybug had laid hundreds of eggs underground, which meant that Sugar Rush is pretty much fucked.
Before the race, King Candy finds Ralph in the absence of Vanellope and offers Ralph his medal, which King Candy has dug into the game's code to retrieve, through the use of the Konami code on an actual NES controller. The only condition was that Vanellope couldn't race. When Ralph asks why King Candy and the other racers hate her so much, he explains he really doesn't. Vanellope is a glitch, and so, This will cause her to act abnormally, such as teleporting and jumping around, sometimes through objects. If she won the race, she'd become an official part of the racing roster. He goes on to explain that her glitching would give gamers the impression that the game was broken, and the game would be unplugged, and thus turning Sugar Rush into Sonic 06 and Sonic Boom Rise of Lyric. While everyone else could be evacuated from the game, Vanellope could not leave, as she is a glitch. As a result, she would die along with the program, so King Candy leaves Ralph with that and Eggsitch.
Kinda like me if my powers ever get drained right out of me, since it's basically my life source.
Luckily, you stopped feeling depressed after that whole near-death experience from that adventure we went on with that other Sonic and his friends.
Yeah, but it's been a year now since it happened. What's going to happen next? I find the true culprit that killed my parents? If that ever happens, I'm gonna get hella depressed from that.
And if that does, just so you know, we're all here for you.
Forever and always.
Thanks, brother.
I don't know if my powers are my life source or not, because my powers got drained twice, but I really don't know much about them.
When Vanellope returns and gives Ralph a cookie medal that says, "You're my hero," he explains to Vanellope that she cannot race for her own good. But she notices that Ralph has the Medal of Heroes and doesn't believe him, threatening to race on her own. Ralph stops her and hangs her by her jacket on a nearby lollipop tree. He then reluctantly proceeds to destroy her cart into pieces. Vanellope tries to stop Ralph, but it was no use. She falls off, saying, "You really are a bad guy," and runs away sobbing.
You were right there.
It just reminds me of something I did to Tails that I'd rather not talk about right now.
You don't have to tell us right away.
I'll tell you when the time is right.
Okay. Also, when Vanellope tells Ralph he's a really bad guy, it kinda hurt me because it reminded me of transforming into my darker self when Laurel was almost killed by Flare's identical twin brother named Flame, and when Dimension 23's Shadow almost shot my girlfriend.
I don't want to turn into a darker version of myself. All that anger, fear, and rage could turn me into something I'm not.
I remember when David turned into his dark self, when my powers were getting drained the first time.
Oh no.
Ralph goes back to Fix-It Felix Jr. and sees that the entire game is deserted, save for one lone citizen, Gene.
I'm right here, and at least you didn't call me Big Gene.
I know. Gene explains that the game was set to be unplugged in the morning, that everyone has evacuated, and that he has stayed behind to enjoy one last martini. Gene did say that he will not dishonor his bets, and gives Ralph the key to the penthouse, since he acquired a medal as agreed. Ralph did not realize the extent of this, saying that he was sick of being alone in the dump, to which Gene resorts that it is over. For now, he can be alone in the penthouse.
David, I'm right here. You're talking about Big Gene. Damn it! Did I just call myself fat?
Gene, you're not fat. You're beautiful just the way you are.
And at last I see the light. And it's like the fog is lifted.
Wow, Laurel and 76 Sonic. Wow.
Alone in the penthouse, Ralph goes to the balcony and in frustration throws his medal at the screen that sits above the game. This causes the out of order sign to begin to fall off, revealing the side of the Sugar Rush arcade cabinet in front of Ralph's game. He discovers that Vanellope is on the cabinet and wonders why she is on the machine's artwork if she is a glitch. Ralph suspects something is fishy, and he returns to Sugar Rush.
Ralph comes after Sour Bill and places him in his mouth as a form of torture until he confesses.
At least it's better than being tortured with a poison dagger, or the Cruciatus Curse.
Or when you, me, Sonic, and Aurora were all being tortured by the Dark Brotherhood.
And Dimension 23 Shadow putting me through hell with all those damn experiments.
Let's not also forget about me almost getting my powers drained. Seriously, has everyone forgotten about that?
Nope, of course not.
Okay, just making sure.
My powers were drained twice, and I went through the worst pain a few months ago. Losing someone that I hadn't seen in 3 years. That I finally got to see again. But for the last fucking time. Because he died in my arms after sacrificing himself to save me.
It's okay, sis. I know that it's still hard on you, but
Now your father is reunited with your mother in heaven. You'll see him again in no time, sis. I promise.
Ooh, baby, do you know what that's worth? Ooh, heaven is a place on earth. They say in heaven, love comes first. We'll make heaven a place on earth. Ooh, heaven is a place on earth.
Thanks, Laurel. I needed that.
Anytime, Jean. So anyway, Sour Bill explains that King Kenny changed Vanellope's coat on purpose. When Ralph asks his motives, Sour Bill says he doesn't know why. In fact, no one knows why. He explains it like this because King Kenny locked up all the character memories and says that if Vanellope crosses the finish line, the game will reset and she won't be a glitch. Upon locating Felix, Ralph begs Felix to fix the wrecked cart so that Vanellope can race. He agrees to do so after discovering how hard of a life Ralph has gone. Also, why does Felix fix everything he touches?
Also, after freeing and making amends with Vanellope, they start the race. And as the race progresses on, the Hatch Cybugs attack Sugar Rush. Felix, Kaloon, and Ralph then battle them. Vanellope catches up to King Candy mid-race, but Candy tries to ram Vanellope off the track. When Vanellope tries to escape, King Candy instantly gets impatient and viciously attacks her with its cane. Vanellope glitching interferes with King Candy's code, revealing that King Candy is actually Turbo in disguise, having someone escape his game before it was unplugged.
Remember me, Vanellope?
When I killed your brother, I talked just like this!
What the shit was that?
It was an impression of Judge Doom from Who Framed Roger Rabbit.
That's right. The biggest connection between Wreck-It Ralph and Who Framed Roger Rabbit is a villain. And King Candy slash Turbo is definitely the same exact character as Judge Doom. Especially with their shocking reveals and their evil plans. Judge Doom was the one who killed Eddie Valiant's brother. But here in Wreck-It Ralph, we see that Turbo not only caused Turbo Time and Road Blasters to be unplugged, but he also invaded Sugar Rush, fucked up the codes, and turned Vanellope into a glitch, while under the persona of King Candy.
Gee whiz, and I thought the tale of Hansel and Gretel made the whole candy concept dark, evil, and fucked up.
Turbo rams his car into Vanellope, causing her to be dragged in front of the car while approaching a wall fork in the road. Vanellope finally takes control of her glitchiness to escape from Turbo, drives away, yelling at her victory. An enraged Turbo tries to pursue, but suddenly a cyborg appears on the track and devours him alive.
The group attempts to flee the Doom game, but Vanellope cannot pass through the exit due to her status as a glitch. Calhoun says the game can't be saved, because there is no beacon in the game. The beacon in Hero's Duty attracts and kills the Cybugs. Neither does Sonic the Hedgehog, unless you count that beam from Sky Sanctuary. But still, if Sonic the Hedgehog was invaded by Cybugs, then it would be fucked. Ralph, in a last-ditch effort, heads to Diekola Mountain, where he plans on collapsing its Mentos stalactites into the cola at the bottom, causing an eruption that would attract the bugs. While on top of the mountain, he pounds the Mentos into the Diet Cola below from the top. However, before he can finish, Turbo, fused with the cybug that devoured him, arrives and stops him. Welcome to the Bosch level!
He's basically a fusion of the Time Eater, Ganon, and Deffenwarf.
Actually, bro, he's pronounced Sephiroth from Final Fantasy.
Son of a beef brisket! Plus, a hint of Bowser and a dash of Dr. Wily.
And don't forget the most important ingredient of them all, Dr. Yes Man!
Get out!
Well then, time to cross cameo number 2 off the list!
Hey Eggman, I need not be kind. I'm the boss. I'm the boss. I'm very, very sorry for your loss. I'm the boss. I'm the boss. And just in case I didn't get my point across, I'm the boss.
He's gone.
Fuck!
Language! We have a birthday girl present.
Well, thank you for showing some respect to me for what?
Sorry, Your Highness.
Hey! Frost is the princess of our family, not me!
Actually, you are kind of a princess. Let's see here. You have magic hair, magic hands, you can talk to animals. I don't think you've been poisoned, but you certainly have been cursed, kidnapped, and enslaved. and people everywhere assume all your problems got solved because a big strong man showed up. So yes, you, Laurel the Cat of Dimension 23, are a goddamn fucking princess!
What? The? Fuck! Dimension 23 Sonic!
Does that mean that I'm a princess?
You'll always be my princess.
I ship it like FedEx!
You're also a princess to me, Cockle, and you'll always be my princess. I ship it like UPS!
It's FedEx, you idiot! Ship it like FedEx! You sound like a damn fool when you say it wrong!
Alright then, FedEx! Turbo declares that he has become the most powerful virus in the arcade, and plans to take over all the other games using his new powers, which means that every single character in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate will be completely weak against the Cybugs, seeing that they are obviously going to be part of the permanent roster. But not before getting revenge on Ralph. Ralph and Turbo battle, but Turbo quickly overpowers Ralph, carrying him above the mountain, and sadistically forcing him to watch Cybugs close in on Penelope. Ralph breaks free and dives towards the mountain, hoping his impact will start the eruption, all while reciting the bad guy oath from the beginning of the film.
I'm bad, and that's good. I will never be good, and that's not bad. There's no one I'd rather be than me.
Seeing Ralph dive towards the mountain, Penelope, in turn, uses her glitching abilities with the goal of catching Ralph. Ralph breaks through the roof of the mountain, but before he is killed in the eruption, Penelope catches him in Crumbelina's cart. The eruption shines a bright light, which in turn draws most of the Cybugs to their destruction. Turbo, being more powerful than the others, is able to resist for a short time, but his Cybug programming overwhelms him, and he flies into the Diet Cola lava as well, killing him. Because video game characters who die outside their own game are unable to regenerate ever. This means that the Cybugs and Turbo die permanently. Game over, assholes!
After Turbo and the Cybugs are defeated, Felix restores the finish line, and Penelope crosses it, restoring her memory as the game's lead character and restoring the ruins of Sugar Rush. Before King Candy fucked up the game codes, Penelope was a princess of Sugar Rush, and they had to respect her as leader, even the ones who bullied her in the past. The games favor her as a character, despite her glitches.
It's likely her ability to teleport short distances is perceived by gamers as a special power rather than a glitch.
Turbo had been destroyed forever.
Sarabelle, Windshell, and Duncan, and the Sugar Rush racers never again heard about him. Felix and Ralph return to Fix-It Felix Jr. in time to show Litwack the game works. And they also gave Q-Bert and Co. a new opportunity to work with Ralph and the crew in a bonus level, sparing it and also giving its characters a new respect for Ralph's work as the villain. Felix later marries Calhoun, with Ralph being the best man and Penelope as the maid of honor, and Sonic appeared in the audience of the wedding too.
And Ralph's favorite part of being the villain in Fix-It Felix Jr. is being lifted up by the Nicelanders and getting a good look at Sugar Rush, seeing Penelope being the main star of the game. And the credits roll, and that was Wreck-It Ralph. Still to this day, it was an honor to be part of the Disney family. What are you talking about? You're not a Disney character. You know what I mean, Sonic. It was an honor being a part of the production of Wreck-It Ralph, but the main focus was not on me.
Or me, for that matter. It was just a great movie filled with fun and adventure around every corner.
Disney never explored the world of video gaming before, and this really knocked it out of the park. This movie features so many likable characters, and it serves as an excellent homage to Who Framed Roger Rabbit. Plus, I could be more happy with the casting choices. John C. Reilly, Sarah Silverman, Jack McBrayer, and Jane Lynch all work perfectly well together to bring us something fun, exciting, and heartwarming.
Plus, Ralph appeared as a playable character in Sonic and All-Stars Racing Transform.
That's right, and so did Danica Patrick.
Not sure we'll end up seeing them in Team Sonic Racing next May.
But still, gamers young and old will love Wreck-It Ralph, and Disney fans young and old will love it too. It's just a perfect film for everybody. And so many other great animated Disney films would soon follow it, like Frozen, Big Hero 6, Zootopia, and Moana. I guess you could say that Wreck-It Ralph is a real game-changer for the Disney animation industry. I'm giving Wreck-It Ralph an S rank. Yep, couldn't agree more. S rank.
You know what? Fuck it. I'm going to start using the ranking system from the most recent Sonic games for movie reviews from now on. I, too, give it an S rank. Me, too. I give it an S rank as well.
S-ranks all around!
Yes, S-rank!
So, Laurel, how's that for a fun birthday activity?
Awesome. Although, a little birdie told me you almost forgot my birthday.
Shit biscuits on rye toast with a sunny side of egg, salt, pepper, garlic, Tabasco sauce, and a side of bacon, gravy, and potato salad. And a pumpkin spice latte to go with it!
You forgot Laurel's birthday? Wow, David! That's so classic!
Oh, you're so going to get it.
Let me guess. I'm getting a demotion with fries for $5.99.
No. You're getting this!
Jiminy Christmas!
You deserve that for getting a special day.
Note to self, never forget Laurel's birthday again. Otherwise, I'm getting the electric whoopee cushion.
Well, that was unexpected. I just hope that Laurel and I don't go through the same storyline of Sonic Forces when we get back to Dimension 23.
I wouldn't jinx anything if I were you, bro. Like, I don't want to really lose my memories before Christmas.
That day 6 years ago, I killed two worthless cats with the power of the Phantom Ruby's dark power. Their little daughter must be dead after what Mephiles Dark did back in Rio 2 summers ago. Now with them out of the way and their pathetic cat, I'll make everyone bow to the power of the Phantom Ruby and bring this Dimension 23 to a dark age. This will be a new era.